Jimmy.
Yeah, usually sharp objects and balloons don't mix, but in this experiment, I'm going to demonstrate how you can poke a skewer all the way through a balloon and not pop it. Okay, so first you take a skewer and then put a little bit of liquid soap onto it, like that, and rub it on, get it all soapy. Alright, and then you take a balloon and get ready. You think it's gonna pop, right? But watch this. It didn't pop. It just went right in and didn't pop. Let's see. Go through the other side. Bam. Just like that. Balloon on a skewer. Let's do that again with a red balloon. Stick it right in there. And it goes right in there like that. And then right out the other side. Bam! So how come the balloon doesn't pop like you would think? Let's first take a look at the molecular structure of the balloon. This balloon is made from natural rubber latex, so it's composed of a lot of long chain molecules. Before the balloon is filled with air, these molecules are all bunched up and bent around like spaghetti noodles. As the balloon is inflated, the molecules start to stretch out, becoming straight. Right now the rubber is under a lot of tension. The molecules are pretty uncomfortable. They want to go back to that tangled noodle state where they can relax. If you could see the balloon from a cross-section point of view, you would see that as the balloon is inflated, the rubber becomes thinner in the mid-area, while remaining thick and unstressed at the ends. When the skewer is inserted into the midsection, the balloon immediately pops. That's because the rubber is stretched really thin right there, and all those spaghetti noodle chain molecules are trying to get back to their bunched up state, while at the same time all the air inside the balloon is trying to get out. This causes the balloon to tear rapidly, thus releasing all the air and making that loud popping sound. But when the skewer is poked through at the ends of the balloon doesn't pop because there's not enough air pressure on the inside for the rubber to stretch very tight right there. So the skewer can go in and out again without the balloon popping. So what's the soap for? Well, it just acts as a sealant around the skewer so the air doesn't leak out slowly. If you try the experiment without the soap, it'll still work, just not as well. If you liked this video, give it a thumbs up, and thank you to all of you who have subscribed to my channel so far. I really appreciate it. And to all of those who haven't subscribed yet, why not? All you have to do is click that subscribe button and you'll get notifications every time I upload a new video. Have fun with your balloons!